All right, good evening. I'm calling the meeting of the Union County Board of Chosen Freeholders of Thursday, April 4th, 2019, the agenda setting meeting. Clerk of the Board, would you please call the roll?
Freeholder Estrada?
Present.
Freeholder Garrettson? Freeholder Granados?
Here.
Freeholder Hudak?
Here.
Freeholder Palmieri Muedad?
Here.
Freeholder Staton?
Here.
Freeholder Williams? Vice Chairman Mirabella?
Present.
And Chair Kowalski?
Here.
Chair, you have 7 freeholders present.
Thank you. Would you please lead us in the prayer and salute to the flag?
Humbly we ask God, the giver of peace and the lover of charity, to give the entire family of nations true agreement with his will, and to grant the light of his spirit on all who work for justice and peace.
Amen. Amen.
Pledge allegiance
to the flag of the United States of America, and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Mr. Clerk, would you please note that Freeholder Williams has joined us, and I will just note that Freeholder Garrettson is not with us tonight because she's representing the board at the funeral for Newark Mayor Kenneth Gibson, and we have a resolution about that on tonight's agenda. Clerk of the Board, would you please read the Statement of Compliance with the Open Public Meetings Act?
The Chair wishes to announce that pursuant to the requirements of New Jersey statutes annotated Title 10, Chapter 4, Section 10 of the Open Public Meetings Act, adequate notice of this meeting of the Board of Chosen Freeholders of the County of Union has been given by mailing the annual meeting schedule for the year 2019, along with periodic changes necessitated by circumstances, to the newspapers circulating within the County of Union who are designated to receive such notice, and by posting the annual meeting schedule for the year 2019 in the Administration Building, and further by filing the annual meeting schedule for the year 2019 with the Office of the County Clerk.
Thank you. I would like to call upon Vice Chairman Mirabella and Freeholder Hudak to join me for tonight's presentations to representatives of the New Jersey Sharing Network as we recognize April as National Donate Life Month.
Good evening, everyone. We are here. We have Elise Glennon from the New Jersey Sharing Network, and we have a presentation this evening for National Donate Life Month. The New Jersey Sharing Network is the key organization in this state for organ and tissue donation, and so they every year and 365 days a year are working in our state to educate residents about organ and tissue donation, and whether if you're checking the box at the motor vehicle office while you're getting your license, and working with families who are dealing with donation, who had a loved one that passed away and had become donors, or individuals who have become recipients and want to give back to the community because they've received the gift from someone who passed on. And so I think the statistics on organ donation, something where one donor can impact up to 8 lives with their organs and up to 75 lives with tissue donation. And it's very important. And you do also a tremendous job educating people in the community and letting people know about organ donation and encouraging people to participate. And we know next year is going to be a big year. You obviously do a lot of tremendous work, but also we're going to be hosting the Transplant Games in 2020, so a lot more work in the run-up to that event. So we're very pleased to have you here for National Donate Life Month, and we have a resolution. We have another resolution to present in a few moments as well, but would you like to say a few words on behalf of the Sharing Network?
Thank you so much, and thank you for having me here tonight. It is National Donate Life Month, as you said, and it's times like this and partnerships with freeholder boards like this and the community at large that helps us to increase organ and tissue donation. In the last 5 years, organ and tissue donation has increased 35%. So the education and the awareness is certainly working, but there's still so much more work to do. There's 115,000 people currently waiting for a life-saving transplant nationally. 4,000 of them live here in New Jersey. And if you are interested in finding out how many people in your town where you live or where you work that are currently waiting for a transplant, we currently have a campaign going on at SaveNJLives.com. SaveNJLives.com, you can just put in your town name and find out how many people in your town are waiting for a life-saving transplant, because chances are that you know someone whose life has been impacted by organ and tissue donation. Either they're waiting or they've received a transplant, or perhaps their loved one passed away and gave that gift at the time of their passing. So again, thank you so much for having us here. Thank you for coming out to our 5K every year. We have one of our biggest, well, the biggest event that we do every year happens in June. It happens in New Providence, which is where our state headquarters is located, right here in your county. So we're so happy to be able to partner with all of you for your continued support.
Well, thank you, Elise. You know, you're no stranger to Union County. You've been working in nonprofit world for a long time and sharing network for a long time now too. And you're a great partner, and you guys do such great work. I want to thank a few people really quickly before I ask Eric to come forward. I have a special story to tell about Eric, who's here. First is Scotch Plains Councilwoman Elizabeth Stamler, who serves on the board at the Sharing Network, who continuously raises the awareness about the importance of organ donation and how in Scotch Plains she can do her part and how at the county we should do our part. So it's been a great partnership with the Councilwoman. I want to thank Dennis McCaffrey, who is the baseball coach of the Cranford High School team. And I think, Eric, you played on that team. And he brought to my attention Eric's story, and I want to ask Eric to come forward, and I'll invite his dad to come forward too. All right, well, maybe we'll take a picture later. So I want to read this. I don't often read this specifically, but it's so important, and the story really touched me that I wanted to have you come up here, Eric, and I'm glad you could make it. Eric attended a charity event in 2017 to benefit Hearts for Emma, and he worked closely with partnership with the New Jersey Sharing Network. Those two groups do work together to raise awareness about organ donation. I guess you were inspired to be an altruistic kidney donor, and I'm going to get into a little bit what that means. You attended the event and underwent testing to become an altruistic kidney donor. And what that really means is that you're not related to the person. You just are freely out there in the world, I guess, and said, I have an organ, and if it matches, I want to donate it to someone, right? So a lot of times family members, because their geology, genealogy or whatever it is, match, it's oftentimes a family thing, but this is something that's really special to me. You waited 7 months after this or on the list, and you had surgery at St. Barnabas, and you were part of a kidney chain. And I read a little bit about this, that if you donate, then someone donates to your family. It's kind of an interesting thing. And, you know, Dennis made sure I knew about this. And, you know, I'm very proud of you personally and on behalf of this board. And I want to really thank you for your selfless gift to someone who saved their life.
Thank you. Thank you.
Well, thank you, everybody. Thank you to the board, Union County, and ultimately the NJ Sharing Network for making all of this possible. It is Donate Life Month, so whatever you can do, like mentioned before, whether it's just checking off that box on the back of your driver's license or learning a little bit more about organ and tissue donation in general, it's a huge help, and it's really molded a portion of my life and several others over this past year or so. So I wanted to thank everybody once again and appreciate the recognition.
And I'd like to add my personal thanks to Elise for the great work that you do with the Sharing Network. And of course, Eric, you and your family, the Wolano family is known in Cranford as a very community involved and creative family. Your mom is an artist. You have been involved in sports. Your whole family is really you're all outstanding members of not only the Cranford community but the Union County community, and we appreciate this selfless effort on your part, and thank you very much. Thank you. We'll do a photo now, if that's okay with you. Okay.
Right now.
Oh,
that's
is that right? Or
she's
doing
her board
So we'll get to the official business of this meeting, and thanks again to the Sharing Network and all the people who participate. And I will call up Sergeant Miller to address the resolution from the Sheriff's Office. Good evening.
Good evening. Chairwoman, my name is Sergeant Miller. I'm representing the Sheriff's on behalf of Depot Valley. I'm talking about the clear water system that we use for our Bureau of Identification. It's a system that includes the hardware and software for imaging, capturing photos, fingerprinting, and allows us to upload and archive all information on the defendant criminally for the Union County Superior Court. The cost of the system is equally shared between the Sheriff's Office and the Prosecutor's Office. The Chief of Staff, Condry, presented this on behalf of the prosecutors last meeting. Chairwoman, I'm happy to answer any questions you may have at this time.
Okay, thank you. Freeholders, any questions? All right, thank you very much.
Thank you.
For the Department of Administrative Services, Director Laura Scutari.
Good evening. The Department of Administrative Services has one resolution request, and I'll try and answer any questions.
Builders, any questions? All right, thank you. Department of Economic Development, Director and Deputy County Manager, Amy Wagner.
Good evening. The Department of Economic Development has two resolutions for your consideration, and I'd be happy to answer any questions you may have.
Realtor Hudak.
Thank you, Chair. Not less of a question and more of a comment. I see that the first resolution is in regard to the 2019 infrastructure grant program. Yes. Thrilled to see that this is continuing.
Yes, thank you for your leadership in bringing that to us the first time.
Yeah, I see Mr. Patterson's here. I know we're not going to rename it this year, but I'm sure he'll be happy to comment next week that we're still spending $1.5 million on roads and infrastructure in Union County. Thank you, Chair.
Thank you. Realtor Granados.
Thank you, Chair. Just in reference to number two, can you elaborate on some of the programs that take place at some of the agencies?
Absolutely. So this would be job training functions for individuals that receive public assistance, whether it's TANF, GA, SNAP. There's a requirement by the state that you have to be in some sort of a job training activity. Those services are offered through Union County College, Workforce Advantage, America Works, ARC of Union County, and it can be a multitude of options for training. They would all typically go through a soft skills training program, and then they can choose, maybe they want to be a forklift operator, or they want to be a person that does medical billing. There's thousands of opportunities that they can select from.
Sounds good. Thank you, Deputy County Manager. Thank you, Chair.
Okay. Freeholder Williams.
Yes, just one question regarding number one.
Yes.
How is the aid apportioned to each municipality? Is it based on their grant request, a specific request?
A number of different factors go into it. We try to take a baseline so that we spread it around. Population has something to do with it, the types of projects that they're choosing to embark upon. It's a lot. It's a committee of the Freehold. The fiscal committee will review them all. But that's typically how it shakes out, that it's pretty close to population related.
Thank you. Thank you, Chair.
Thank you. All right. Thank you, Deputy County Manager. Department of Human Services, Director Debbie Ann Anderson.
Good evening. The Department of Human Services has three resolutions on for tonight, and I'll be happy to answer any questions you may have.
I think they're self-explanatory. Thank you, Director.
Thank you.
Department of Parks and Recreation, Director Ron Zuber.
Good evening, Chair and Freeholders. Department of Parks and Recreation has one item on tonight's agenda, and I'll try to answer any questions you have.
Freeholder Hudak.
Thank you, Chair. Less of a question and more of a comment regarding the management over at the Warnaco Sports Center. I thought, you know, visited the center a number of times over the course of the winter. I just wanted to pass along, you know, kind words to the staff there. They did an excellent job. The ice quality was fantastic. The everything just worked very well. And, you know, it was my observation that the residents really liked the upgraded facilities there. So, you know, my child participated in the ice skating lessons. Actually, they both tried. One enjoyed it, one sat on the ice one day and never went back out.
Been there.
But yeah, exactly. But nevertheless, I really do want to pass along a commendation to the staff there because they did an excellent job this winter. And it seems that people really took to the new center, and it's becoming a very you know, popular addition to the park.
Thank you very much. I'll pass that along.
Thank you, Chair.
Freeholder Estrada.
Thank you. So, Ron, this means that the Sports Facility Management LLC, which is the original company that we contracted, is no longer doing the service, and they have passed on their contractual responsibility to Kemper.
Correct. They Kemper had 4 months from November to the end of March, picking up where SFA left doing business with us, and now this is amending that resolution to start again with Kemper.
Right, but in other words, this other company, the Sports Facility Management LLC, has relinquished their contract altogether, and now strictly Kemper Sport. Is it an individual contract, or is it a joint contract with the golf course?
Freeholder, I don't know that right now, but
County Council.
It's an individual contract, separate and apart.
Separate and apart. From the
yes.
We're all separate. Rest.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Okay. Thank you, Director.
Thank you.
County Council.
Thank you, Madam Chair. The Office of the County Council has one item on tonight's agenda, and I'd be happy to answer any questions.
All right, and we'll move on to Freeholder-sponsored resolutions. I did mention the resolution for the family of Mayor Gibson, and I'm thinking perhaps we would want that from the entire board.
Yes.
And are there any other friendly amendments or additions for Freeholder resolutions? Yes, Freeholder Staten.
I'd like to be added to number 3, please.
Oh, maybe we should make that the entire board as well. I think so. That's agreeable. Okay. Freeholder Hudak?
Chair, I'd like to join, with his permission, Freeholder Mirabella, celebrating John Meat Market 80th anniversary.
Sure.
Okay.
It's number 6.
Mm-hmm. And I'd like to join Vice Chairman Mirabella on number 7. Thank you. Anyone else?
Oh, may I join that
yeah.
as well?
Yeah. Okay.
Sorry.
And I may have a couple of additional auditories, which I'll let you know about, Mr. Clerk.
Duly noted.
All right. So I think we've concluded the evening's business. May I have a motion to adjourn?
So moved.
Second.
Aye.
All in favor? Aye. Yes, thank you. Called by the vice chair and seconded by Freeholder Williams. Thank you, everyone.